verses 5 and 6. They read very simply. Happy are those whose strength is in you, in whose heart are the highways to Zion. As they go through the valley of Baca, they make it a place of springs. I'm going to stop there. Title very simple, nothing too complicated. Going through Baca. Going through Baca. The purpose of this message is to suggest that when we go through something with God, we are strengthened. Our souls are renewed. Our faith is affirmed. By going through something, we learn just how good life is. How good love is. How good joy is. How good God is, yes. And how resourceful we are, simply because we have gone through something. It is the realization of understanding firsthand what the writer of Psalm 84 was thinking. Happy are those whose strength is in you, in whose heart are the highways to Zion, as they go through the valley of Baca. They make it a place of springs. So what does it mean to go through the Valley of Baca? Perhaps when I say the Valley of Baca, that is a phrase that is unfamiliar to you. But there are other words, however, that we could use to substitute the word Baca. Another name for Baca could be loneliness. Another name could be despair. Hopelessness, despondency, dejection, the blues, gloom, absurdity, sadness, melancholy. Anywhere, any place, anytime one is going through something, they may very well be going through the Valley of Baca. But the text says that in order to get to Zion, we must go through the Valley of Baca.
Yeah.
Baca, which means the weeping valley of misery, is not on anyone's map. No geographer can locate its whereabouts. It is only referenced this one time in the Bible. Therefore, those who spend the vast majority of their time trying to prove the Bible wrong take great joy in revealing that no such place exists on the map. They can't find Baca. They will tell you Baca does not exist. They will tell you it is pointless to read the Bible for historical accuracy. They will tell you the Bible is not grounded in fact. But if you've ever been through a trying time in your life, if you know firsthand how gut-wrenching pain feels, if the concept of joy has felt like a distant, remote, unattainable goal reserved for somebody else, then you know for yourself Baca is real. You know what going through Baca means. You know that Baca does not have to be on the map to be historically accurate. Baca may not be on the map, but it's in the Bible. And it's in the Bible because it's in the human condition. Maybe there is someone here going through the Valley of Baca right now. Maybe 2012 thus far has been a Valley of Baca for you. Baca doesn't have to be on the map in order to be real. No one can pinpoint the exact location of hell, but you and I both know folks who catch it every day. But we need to examine the significance of the psalmist's words when traveling through the Valley of Baca. For Baca to be a valley means at some point water ran through that area. Now the water is gone. Where once life was abundant, it is no more. The lack of water has an impact on one's ability to survive. We are told that we should drink at least 8 glasses of water per day. better because it is a key ingredient to good health. Water is one of the precious gifts that ensures our survival. Now the psalmist tells us that Baca is void of that ingredient. Where once water ran through, now it is only dust, which means Baca is a dead place. Many of the inner city urban areas were once thriving communities. The waters of prosperity flowed like a mighty stream. One could find a good job, buy a home, raise a family, feel safe, but today, the water of prosperity has dried up, turning many urban areas into valleys of Baca. Few of us want to end up in the valley. You Bible readers know that biblical references are seldom complimentary when one experiences the valley. It is in the valley that represents the worst that life has to offer. It is in the valley where the basic needs of survival become scarce. It is the suffocating conditions of the valley that makes us uncomfortable to move forward. But it's also in the valley where God does some of God's best work. We serve a God that exists in the valley. Ezekiel was in the valley of dry bones, and the Lord breathed life into that which was dead. David said, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for thou art with me. Isaiah reminds us that every valley shall be exalted. Every mountain hill shall be made low. The crooked place is made straight, and the rough place is smooth. And the glory of the Lord shall be with you, and all flesh shall see it together. Now verses 5 and 6 reveal three important lessons why we must go through the valley of Baca. First reason is, happy are those whose strength is in the Lord. We do not make it on our own strength. So we need the one who can increase our strength. This is the lesson learned in the Samson story. It was not until Samson lost his strength that he prayed, Lord, try me one more time. I know I've let you down, but try me one more time. Please strengthen me one more time. Samson had to go through humility, loss of physical strength, and social standing to realize that it was God's strength that was the source of his strength.
Come on. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Psalm 121 says, when I lift my eyes unto the hills, I know where my help comes from. If you read that psalm, the help doesn't come from the hills.
Come on.
The help comes from the Lord. The blessings come from the Lord. The strength comes from the Lord. That's why Howard Thurman reminds us when we're down and out and void of strength, there's a strength beyond our strength, giving strength to our strength.
Yes,
blessed are those whose strength is in the Lord, those who depend on the Lord, those who trust in the Lord.
Yes.
When your strength is in the Lord, you may be in the valley, but the valley is not in you. You may be in trouble, but trouble is not in you. You may have a sorrow, but earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. I don't have to tell you, these are tough times. We're on the cusp of global chaos. Congress has turned its back on the poor in order to help the rich. External pressures make it harder for families to make ends meet. Teenagers are wrestling with decisions and life choices that were once reserved for adults. We need to know that there's a God in the valley. We need to know that God is my refuge and strength. That God is my light, my salvation, my joy, my all. God is the strength of my life, the joy of my soul, the peace of my existence, the measure of my hope, and the power of my faith. Blessed is the man. Blessed is the woman. Blessed is the child. Blessed is the community. Blessed are the people whose strength is in the Lord. But the text doesn't stop there. Blessed is the person whose strength is in the Lord, who in whose heart are the highways to Zion. The second reason we've got to go through Zion is because the path leads to Zion through our heart. There are several ways that we could define Zion, but I'm defining it this morning as the place that has been sacredly devoted to God. That place where you and God are the closest. That's Zion. Now somebody says it's Jerusalem, okay. But for us, that place where you and God are the closest. Zion. If you are on your way to Zion, it is your heart that will lead you there. You can't get to Zion on tithes and offerings alone. You can be the biggest giver in the church, but that will not determine if you're on your way to Zion. That does not mean you shouldn't die. Amen. It means that your heart will determine your spiritual journey. If your heart is to be a highway to Zion, you cannot fill it with negativity.
All right.
You can't spend your time judging other folk. You can't spend your time worrying about what someone else has and what someone else might be doing. Mess in your heart can take you off the highway that leads to Zion. Every follower of Jesus ought to read Matthew chapter 5, 6, and 7, otherwise known as the Sermon on the Mount. One of its main points is that our actions are often based on our relationship with God. How we treat others, how I treat somebody, has to do more with my relationship with God. Am I going to keep my end of the bargain than it does with the other person? How you treat the other person is a direct reflection on how you feel about yourself. If your relationship with God is unclear, check your heart. If you're not sure that you're on your way to Zion, check your heart. If church is more of a social gathering than spiritual rejuvenation, check your heart.
Amen.
Is your heart a highway to Zion? Or have you set up roadblocks?
Come on now.
What you have in your heart will determine your direction. That's why the psalmist says, blessed is the person whose strength is in the Lord, in whose heart are the highways to Zion. Finally, the third reason is the one that brings us good news. Verse 6, as they go through the Valley of Baca, they make it a place of springs. Going through the Valley of Baca is not a pleasant experience. I don't have to tell you that. Everybody has a Baca, you know, in their mind. They know what Baca looks like. On the surface, you will see only what is dry, a dusty, desolate place that once had an abundance of life. But life is no longer there. The only life in Baca are scavengers, vultures, jackals, ready to pounce on your dead carcass. Unfortunately, you must go through the Valley of Baca. The human condition is set up that way. Not around Baca. Not over Baca.
Gotta go through it.
Gotta go through Baca. Why? If you do not go through the Valley of Baca, you are not on your way to Zion.
Yeah. Amen.
The road through Baca leads to Zion. Going through Baca gives your faith a foundation that's not easily shaken. Going through Baca brings you closer to God because it's only then that you taste and see that the Lord is good. Your faith will not grow by the testimonies of others alone. You will never raise your hand and shout hallelujah solely based on my testimony.
Come on.
You must have your own story, your own testimony, your own song, how you and God traveled through Baca while on your way to Zion.
Yes.
You must be able to sing the way Ricardo sang last week so passionately. I want Jesus to walk with me in my trials, walk with me in my troubles, walk with me in my sorrow, walk with me while I'm going through the Valley of Baca. Walk with me. People come to church all the time, can't say nothing, can't feel nothing, mainly because they ain't been through nothing. You must know God for yourself. You must know Jesus for yourself. You must know the Holy Spirit for yourself.
Yes.
Again, in verse 6, as they go through the Valley of Baca, they make it a place of springs. While Baca may look deserted on the surface,